Hey y'all, if you've been around CNC for more than a couple hours or two, you're probably looking for artwork. And sometimes this is complex vectors to create a nice 3D design or what have you. Other times you may be just looking for something small and simple, you know? There are tons of sources out there online. Some of you can draw them yourselves. But occasionally, if you're looking for something small and simple, you have a source on your Windows-based PC that you probably either didn't know you had or you knew you had and just forgot. I'm talking about dingbats. Yeah, dingbats, like web dings and wing dings and things like that. Like I say, they come with every version of Windows, and they're already installed on your computer. And believe me when I say you can go online and find a ton more. You can literally fill up your hard drive with dingbats. But in this video, I'm going to show you how to import them into V Carve Pro using the draw text command, and how to go online, find some more, download and install some new dingbats. So stick around. Let's head for the computer.
Okay, when we get over here into V Carve Pro, selecting one of the image objects used in a dingbat or a wing dings font is very simple. We'll come over here to draw text and select that window, and we'll scroll down to the wing dings font and I'll select number one. So we've got our wing dings font selected. And now what do you do? Well, if you happen to know which letter, number, or special character to push on your keyboard to get the object you want, then you're fine. But if you don't know which button to push to get a specific image, or even what images there are, how do you find out? I mean, yeah, you can go through and push every button and try it, but that's a big investment in time. Well, something else that Windows has, all versions of Windows has this, and that is something called the character map. Now, some of you may know what it is and have used it, and some people may have never even heard of it and didn't know what it is. Well, the character map is there to give you a visual representation of all the characters that are available to you in a font set. And the way you find the character map, in Windows 7, you come down here to the Start menu, go to All Programs, and hit Accessories, then System Tools, and Character Map is right here. And when you're in Windows 10, the way you get to the character map is click on your Start, then scroll way down. It's now under Windows Accessories, right here. Like so. Okay, now the character map, as I said before, is here to show you all of the characters that are available within this font set. So we're looking at Arial here, and we can see there are a lot of characters in there, probably a lot that you never even knew existed. But that doesn't help us when it comes to finding the symbols and the wingdings that we were looking for. So to change that, we'll hit this menu here and we'll scroll down until we find wingdings. And there are all the symbols that are installed in the wingdings font. These are all the symbols and characters that are available for use. And you can see there's all kinds of little things in here. So the way we will select one to use, however, is, let's say we need a left arrow. Okay, so we've got one here, one there. I think I like this one. So I'll just put my cursor over it, click it once, and you see how it expands. That lets me know that I have selected it. Then I'll come down here to the select button. And you'll notice the arrow appears in this blank next to characters to copy. It will copy more than one character if you want it. I only want the one left arrow right now to use in my sign, so I'll go ahead and I'll click the copy button. That's now saved to my clipboard. So I can come back over here to VCarve Pro, making sure that I have the Wingdings font here that I've selected, come up into this window, right click, and click paste. Now it pasted the letter I, a lowercase I, with two dots over the top. So that's what we would enter if we knew that's what we were after before we went into the character map. So I'll hit apply, and there's our arrow. And that's now ready to be used just as you would any other vector image. Now I will show you one thing on it. It is treated as a vector image. It is not a set of vectors that you can get in and edit. The way you would do that, convert it to curves. Come down here into the edit objects, fit curves to selected vectors. Make sure that you have a check mark here to replace selected vectors. And then you can decide which type of vectors you want to go with, whether you want circular arcs, Bezier curves, or straight lines. I don't have any curves here. I don't have any arcs. I don't have any kind of a curve line. They're all straight lines, so I'm going to go ahead and go with straight lines. Preview that, and that shows me how many control points that I have within the vectors. That's the one I'm going to select. I'll hit OK. And there we go. Now it's completely editable. And we're ready to use this in our drawing. Now, Wingdings happens to be the name of that font, but what it's actually called as a collective name is a dingbat. Yeah, a dingbat. So you're not pinned to the ones that come with your Windows program. You can go online and search for a whole bunch more. And believe me when I say there are a bunch. We just go in here and do a Google search, and we'll look for dingbats, which obviously is something that I have already searched for several times. And I found that my two favorite sources for fonts at all are dafont.com and 1001 fonts. Now there are a whole bunch more, believe me, but I usually find that if I can't find something I like on Dafont, I'll go down to 1001 fonts and usually find something there. So I'm going to go ahead and go to this website here, Dafont, and you can see this has opened up all of the dingbat font types there are. Now you see here we got 123 pages of these. So it's very, very easy to go crazy on this and completely overload your system with all of these little images here. I mean, and believe me, I have almost fallen into the trap a couple of times, because I mean, you know, when you're in VCarve Pro, you'll use little flourishes and scrolls like this all over the place. But it's not limited to flourishes and scrolls. I mean, you see these little banners here, and all of them are scalable. I'm going to avoid brand names and logos just simply because of copyright, etc. But you begin to see some of these decorative things that you can find in here. And I mean, they're all over the place. So I'll go back up to these scrolls and flourishes here. And this was called Nymphet. And I'm going to go with this one here. This was called Bergamot. Okay. Ornaments. Why not? And one of the things I like about this particular website is it lets you know right over here that it's 100% free, be that for commercial use or for personal use. You can see some of them up here, like this one here is free for personal use. This one also is free for personal use, meaning that they'll want you to pay a small fee if you're going to use it for commercial use. Well, That's all well and good. I don't think that I'm going to be using this for commercial use, but even if I do, it's 100% free. So that's great. Now I'll go over here and I'll click on just any of those images, and it brings me over to this page where it shows me what each character that I type on the keyboard is, what symbol that's going to bring up. So here we're in the capital letters, and there are some neat flourishes here and scrolls. And this is the lowercase letters, and there are some very, very nice scroll work here. And then we get into numerals and special characters. And as I say, you can see for yourself, a person could really go crazy overloading their computer with things of this nature. So I kind of like some of these scrolls. I'm going to go ahead and download this to my computer so I can show you how to install a font. Now, its title is Bergamot Ornaments TTF, which stands for True Type Font, which is what we're after. That is a completely scalable vector graphic. So we'll go ahead and we'll download this, and I'm going to put it in my downloads folder. It's going to save it as a zip file. Save that. And I'm using Chrome as my browser. And one of the things I like about Chrome is once it's downloaded, I've got this little arrow up here. That I click that arrow and look at this context menu, I've got show in folder. That way I don't have to remember and search for all of the folder that I just downloaded. So I'll double click that to open it, and I see extract all files. This works this way in Windows 10 as well. It's just slightly different, that's all. So I'm going to go ahead and extract the file into the same folder that I downloaded the zip file into. And I put a check mark over here to show extracted files when complete. Then I'll click extract. And that extracted that file from the zip file here, so it's ready for use, ready for me to install, rather. And the way to do that is just select it, right click, and then click install. It's now finished and it's ready for use. Now, sometimes VCarve Pro, you can come right over here to text and go into your fonts and look for it. And sometimes it'll be there ready to go, and such as right now, it is there and ready to go. Other times, if you don't see it in your font menu here, you'll need to restart VCarve Pro and it will appear then. So I've selected my Bergamot Ornaments and I've clicked up here. Now I'm going to go down to my character map, load it up, and see what I downloaded. See, get up here to it, Bergamot Ornaments, and there they are. And I think I'm going to play around a little bit with, let's see, was it this one? Yes, I'm going to play around with that one. So I'll select it, copy, come over here, right click, paste. So it was capital W is what I needed. Apply, close, and you can see it put it right here. So I'll align to the center of my material, and there it is. So what we've done is we've checked out our Wingdings font set. We downloaded a new type of Dingbat font set, installed it. We played around a little bit with the character map to learn how to use that to not only figure out which characters are which, but how to then copy those characters to the clipboard and put them in our project using the draw text tool. So if you got anything at all out of this video, I do hope you'll give me a thumbs up down there. And if you'd like to see more, be notified whenever I post a new video, consider subscribing to my channel. But whether you do that or not, I'd like to thank you very much for watching. Y'all take care.